Last month, the private sector launched a campaign to boost COVID-19 vaccinations in the Philippines. For how that's going, we now have with us Margot Torres. She is the co-lead of the Ingat Angat Communications Advocacy. She is also the managing director of McDonald's Philippines. Good morning, Ms. Margot.
Good morning, Nikki and Mike.
Thank you for joining us. All right, so first off, let's get straight to the point. How exactly do the participating brands, businesses, and media companies of the Ingat Angat Bakuna Lahat campaign of the government aid the government's vaccination program?
We all help with Task Force T3, that is a private consortium of multiple conglomerates and private companies. And actually, I should say thank you to you guys, to ABS-CBN, because you are one of the media partners who have contributed to make sure that the message of building vaccine confidence is heard. And I think we have seen several surveys and our vaccine willingness is at a 32% level in the recent SWS survey. But I think the more important point is more than half of the Filipinos, regardless of social eco class, regardless of educational attainment or place or the region in the Philippines, are uncertain. And uncertain does not mean they do not want to be vaccinated. Clearly, they are in a wait and see mode, or perhaps they have some fears. And this campaign reminds you why you should get vaccinated. So I hope you've seen it.
Ms. Margot, we know that the campaign appeals to our desire to go back to our lives pre-pandemic, you know, and the process of in the process hasten also our country's vaccination efforts. So how important is the support of the private sector to achieving herd immunity the soonest?
So what this campaign is only one component, Nikki. We also have private sector hospitals or healthcare providers such as AC Health, Metro Pacific Hospitals, Mount Grace Hospitals, St. Luke's, and the Medical City. And they have, despite having to deal, you know, with their own COVID cases, they have given manpower and agreed to contribute to a total of 150,000 jabs to augment already the preparation at the LGU level. And I think that's important nowadays, considering we've already opened to A4, and we are expecting more vaccines to arrive in June, July, and August.
Ms. Margot, we're seeing big companies like McDonald's, where you work, you know, SM Supermalls, Unilab, BDO Globe, etc., and the list goes on, participate and support this campaign. But Are startup or small businesses also welcome or encouraged to become partners?
Yes, absolutely. This is a very inclusive campaign. We've made all our visual assets and campaign materials available on the website. So that's ingat-angat.com. Any of the smaller companies, as you call them, can download it. They can even brand it. So there are co-branding guidelines. I think beyond just using the campaign, all companies, big or small, have the responsibility also to build confidence among their own employees. And you know, we have a large workforce, especially at McDonald's, and we've done our efforts. So we're actually at a pretty good willingness level, considering the 32% I mentioned earlier. Nationally as a norm, we are at 90%. So it's really spending time to educate your employees. And we've done about 2 town halls and we've seen our numbers jump just as they listen to the plan of the national government, as well as to medical experts. I think people are inundated with all kinds of news here and abroad. It can get quite confusing. So I think it's important that if a company, especially their CEO, the head, if they really endorse the vaccine and encourage their employees to do so, they will see a lift in their willingness. We in fact have an internal comms toolkit also in the website that guides companies what they need to do.
That being said, Ms. Margot, is this multimedia campaign also coordinating or working in line with the government's Res Bakuna program and, you know, other concerned agencies? Do you have both the business and medical communities backing?
Yes. So the Task Force T3 actually works closely with the National Task Force Vaccine Cluster. So I belong to the Communications Technical Working Group. So I work hand in hand with the DOH and the Res Bakuna campaign. In fact, another private sector company has helped them there. One of our agencies, DDB Philippines. And we've injected the discipline of marketing, making sure that it addresses the right target market. Nikki, there's one more aspect. So I mentioned the 150,000 jobs of the private sector, private healthcare providers. I mentioned the campaign, mentioned internal communications. We recently launched as well an incentive for consumers. And we call this the Smart
Bakuna,
the Smart Bakuna Benefits Program. We're very excited about it because about 156 restaurant brands have participated. Each of them have their own discount, encouraging people to dine in. Some of them also have a discount on takeout. And the belief really is if you already have the added protection from the vaccine, then you know you are safe to go out. And of course, all our restaurants practice all the minimum safety protocols, and it is a safe zone. That will end August 31 because it's all restaurants, but already we're getting interest from other retail outlets, so gasoline stations, non-food outlets. We're also talking to malls for their non-food clients or tenants, and we will extend that promotion in a phase two, including everybody who's interested to offer a discount. And I think whether you're at the first dose or second dose, if you show your vaccination card coming from the LGU, you can already avail of the discount. So we're excited about that. That just launched actually June 1.
All right, and then that being said, lastly, just to further entice our audience on the benefits of the campaign, what would you say are some of the biggest discounts or perks you can get out of this campaign as a person vaccinated?
Well, aside from McDonald's, we also work closely with our friendly competitor, Jollibee Food Corporation. And we all have stores nationwide, right? And both of us have the same discount. And if you are going to buy, like for your personal consumption, we both offer 10% off the bill. As long as it's for your personal consumption, and this is really for dine-in.
All right. Thank you so much for joining us, Ms. Margot Torres.
Okay. Good morning.